one of my best science events in my mind occurred when I was watching that movie Jurassic Park. I don't know if you guys seen that, the first one. And there was that physicist putting that drop of water on his hand and showing that one stream went this way, and had it dropped a little differently, it would have gone other way. I don't know if you remember that particular scene. But that to me was chaos and reality all at the same time. And we try showing that small things could have big amplifications, but at the same time, we understand how it is. And I think when we are trying to say that we know some things and we don't know some things, just means that we know we don't know some things. That is also knowledge. And that is where we can start putting all these risks together. It again boils down to this fact. How much risk are you willing to take? If you're completely risk averse, then you need something with a different degree of confidence, as against someone who just wants to live a life which is out there. So conveying this aspect of what we have in terms of our knowledge base, and there are certain things which are certainly known for a fact. Carbon dioxide levels are changing. Data, can't argue on that. One could say we could have discussions on what is causing that change, but that's a whole different topic. One could again have issues on the processes that are causing the change. But if change is happening, and if it is going to affect you, it is up to you whether you're going to react to it or not. And that kind of aspects, finding some common grounds, always helps us in communicating this aspect. And then once we have that common ground, I think it has been helpful to say, we don't know this. Once we know this, perhaps you can take a more definitive way of going A or B. But I think it's just that aspect that even though we do not know, knowing that we do not know is knowledge. And we can build off that. That's something we try to highlight all the time in what we do.